If you have a video you want to post on social media, it's typically vertical, but if the video itself is horizontal and there's a lot of action going on in there that prevents you from being able to crop the video, there is a effect that people use to move the video in the background and blur it so it fills up the entire space so you don't have black bars on top and the bottom. Let me show you how to do this in Descript because it's a little trick. So let's go to Descript. I have a blank composition here, and in my media bin at the top, I actually imported a stock media with some people skateboarding, and there's my video right there. So I'm going to put this on my video in the middle of the screen, and I want to blur the background and have the same action going on in the background. And if you drag that video, if you're tempted to drag that video into your composition, do not do that. That is wrong. You need a sequence first. Okay, so I'm going to undo this and let's go back to a sequence. Go to the media bin and from this video, create a sequence. Right click on it and say create sequence. And this is the main video. Let's call this one main video in the left track, you know, sidebar there. And now I want to duplicate this video. Okay, so I want to go back to add media. And I want to click that video again and add it as a new track. That's step one. Now, if you have video that has sound on it, to prevent double the sound, to prevent duplicated audio, you need to click on this track here and mute it from the button at the top saying mute track. You want to mute the track so the audio doesn't duplicate. Now let's blur this one. Let's call this one video, blurred video. There you go. And I've got these two tracks in here and I'm ready to do the effect. The reason I added two tracks is because Descript allows you to apply a blur effect to one of the layers. These two layers will be exposed in your composition. Now let's click done. I'm done here. And from this media bin again, go to sequences and there you should find the sequence we just created that has the two layers on it. This is what you want to add to your composition. Before we do that, though, let's make our composition vertical, right? So I can move this out of the way or I can close it. At the top here, you have aspect ratio and video settings. I want to click and change that to portrait, 9:16. Now I'm ready to bring my video in and I'm going to bring that sequence in, go to the media bin again, and this time grab the sequence and drop it in here. You may see the video showing twice because obviously we have two tracks in there. So I'm going to close the media bin. I don't need it anymore. And two of these videos are, if I click outside of this video area on the sidebar, you can see the two tracks and the names we gave them, main video and blurred video. I'm going to get the blurred video, select that one first. It's the one on the right. And I'm going to make it fill the screen. Yeah. So I can move it to the top corner and resize it and then pull the bottom part right there to fill the screen like this. And now for the second one, click the first video, the main video, and let's stretch this one to be like as large as we can and possibly change it and move it in the center. Descript allows you to see those snapping lines so you know the object is in the middle. There you go, I've got the two tracks now. And because they're in the sequence and because they're synchronized in a different track, each one of them, they will play in sync. Watch this. There you go. These are the videos playing in sync. So that will be great because if you have to make any cuts or any changes in the composition, both will be cut in the same place. Now for the final step, I want to click on the background layer there and I want to apply the blur effect to it. Go to the effects on the sidebar, click plus, and add blur. And by default, it's kind of not very blurry. I'm going to click on the options of the effect and I can change the radius of the blur very, very high, sort of like this, possibly even more. Maybe you can do the maximum if you want. And there you go. You can also change the opacity if you want that video to not be so strong or so visible by clicking on the opacity here and dragging down like this, maybe. So here we go. That's my effect right now. The videos are playing, there's a background blur effect in the background, and there you go. And if the action on the screen allows you, you can also grab this video, the main video, and just expand it a little bit. It will crop it like this and like this. And also, if you want to maybe change where the action is visible, like the camera angle, you can double click on it and you see this grid appearing. That means you are now in crop mode and you can shift the video inside of the camera viewport or whatever you want to call it like this. So I can see those two guys in there and the guy on the side. Click done. And there you go. Now I have sort of shifted my video inside of that viewport. So let's play from the beginning now. So you see there's the action and one of the videos is obviously in the middle of the screen and the other one is in the background. There you go. That's how you do it. And you can use this area here to add titles or whatever, subtitles, text, whatever you want to add. So the videos are playing in sync as always. There you go. That's how you achieve the blur effect with Descript. Easy to do. Takes a couple of steps. And the trick is that you're using that duplicated track. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you want more, feel free to subscribe on my channel and also check out my Media Members Club, where I have all these videos and more, and also Descript courses, Camtasia courses, and so much more stuff in there, plus Q&A sessions every week. So thank you again, and I will see you in the next one.